calls them his home movies, but they are also a piece of history. NASA astronaut Dr. Bernard Harris broke barriers. In 1995, he became the first African American to walk in space, a goal he set at 13 when he watched Neil Armstrong do it.
When they landed on the moon, I said I wanted to follow their footsteps. And that's despite not seeing someone who looked like me or anyone who looked like me.
It's not every day children get to ask a real-life astronaut questions face-to-face, or in this case, on Zoom. But Dr. Harris, who is also a physician who founded his own institute to improve the quality of education in underserved communities, took the time to show Pontiac middle school students the sky is the limit.
Liftoff. You can't be an astronaut. You're black. It's like, oh, yes, I can. And so I guess a lesson there is we all have dreams. We're all human beings. Doesn't matter the color of your skin. The most important thing is what's up here. So using this brain to accomplish whatever it is you want to.
The Oakland County chapter of the Lynx, which has spearheaded STEAM programming for Metro Detroit students, sponsored the special session with Dr. Harris, who shared his long-term vision, which included life in space.
Why is that exciting to me? Because that tells me that within a very few short years, we're going to have people going into space on a regular basis. And you don't necessarily have to be a professional astronaut to do that. It will just become the way of life.
And while some may have taken issue with space tourism, Dr. Harris made it clear this is just another step for mankind. He just wants to make sure communities of color are not left behind.
There will be life and jobs on Earth, and there will be life and jobs in space. And I think that that is, as the Star Trek folks would say, the final frontier.
With the children of the future, I'm Taryn Asher, Fox 2 News.